the Middle East.
My name is Benjamin.
And I'm Shlomo.
Are you doing that thing again?
What thing?
Anyway, you know Bethlehem because of the miraculous events that have occurred here and the birth of the Messiah. But before Jesus was born here, Bethlehem had a little different reputation. See, you weren't known as Bethlehem the Brave, or Beautiful Bethlehem, or Happy Bethlehem, or Sad Bethlehem, or Dusty Bethlehem, or Soggy Bethlehem. Oh, so you already know.
They know.
We were known as
Boring Bethlehem.
Watching sheep.
Keeping inns.
Making bread, of course.
Yeah, house of bread. Woohoo! And we pay taxes.
Boy, do we pay taxes. Taxes, taxes, taxes.
Hey, which do you think is worse? Death or paying taxes?
Well, I've only experienced one of those things.
Oh, really? Which one?
Well, we pay a lot of taxes in Bethlehem. And all through Judea. That's actually how the whole story began.
There you go with that old wives' tale again. There's no Messiah coming to rescue us.
today, children. I don't feel up to it. All right, all right. Let's see. Where did we leave off? The prophets, I think. Is it? Yes. Isaiah.
It is for us a child is born. It is for us a son is given. And the government shall be on him. And his name shall be called Emmanuel. God is with us.
Thank you. Shadow of an angel, oh, yeah.
I think they're expecting some tourist traffic.
Thanks. So is that the end of the story? Is that everyone saved? We can all go home?
Well, it's not that easy. Jesus would go on doing everything required for the salvation of the world. But God doesn't force that kind of salvation on people. People have to choose it for themselves. Unfortunately, many people choose other things that they think will save them.
Thank you.
story.
This calls for a celebration! Raise the bread for everyone!
Would you stop with the bread already? Hey, would you like to go join them for the closing number?
Hey, that sounds like fun!
Okay, put down your bread and let's get in line.
Well, I'll get it back.